definitely recommend if you're into thrillers, obviously, because this is a thriller recommendation video. Hello everybody, it's your girl Jay, and today I'm here with my annual thriller recommendation video in the month of October. This is video 4 on this topic on my channel, so I will leave the past 3 videos and any other related videos down below if you want to check those out. Obviously, if I talked about books in those videos, I'm not going to talk about them in this video, so definitely check out those other 3 videos if you want a lot more thriller recommendations. And without further ado, let us get started. The first thriller recommendation I have is Baby Teeth by Zoji Stage. This book is like a little bit controversial to have on this list because a lot of people did not like it, but I, for one, gave it 5 out of 5 stars. I was so intrigued by it when I read it. It follows a 7-year-old named Hannah who doesn't talk. She loves her daddy, but she wants her mommy gone. The mother, Suzette, tries to tell her husband about Hannah's mischievous ways and everything that she does behind his back, but he doesn't believe her. And she's not sure how much longer she can take of Hannah's antics before she snaps, and it's the story of that. I actually listened to this on audiobook, and there's chapters from Hannah's perspective, which was honestly really interesting because Hannah doesn't talk, so you actually got to hear what she was thinking and like the way that she was justifying everything that she was doing to her mother was just so creepy. I'm a huge sucker for the evil child trope, so I really enjoyed it. Everything in this book is written for shock factor, so if that's not your thing, then you're not gonna like this. But like I said, I'm a sucker for the evil child, so I really, really liked it. The next thriller recommendation I have is called The Arrangement by Robin Harding. I've talked about this book on my channel before because when I read it, I loved it so much, but this follows a girl named Nat who has been struggling financially. She is an art student in New York, and then she discovers a website that allows for rich older men to sponsor younger attractive women. She ends up going into an arrangement with a man named Gabe, and she falls instantly in love, only to find out that Gabe actually has a family of his own. She wants him to leave that family for her. He refuses, and that's kind of when she decides that she's going to befriend his daughter, who is around the same age as her, and kind of infiltrate his life that way. But then a body is discovered outside of Gabe's apartment, and things get a little bit messy, and it's like the story of that. But like I said, I was obsessed with this book when I read it. I actually read this book in 2 sittings. It is so addictive. You have to keep reading. The chapters are very, very short, so you fly through the book no problem. The entire book, like, I honestly did not know who I was rooting for because Gabe is such a manipulative asshole, but you like feel for him because like Nat's insane. But also like Gabe, it's your own fault for going into an arrangement when you're married with a whole ass child. You know what I mean? I just really liked the whole blurring of the relationship lines because you couldn't tell if Gabe was actually falling in love with Nat or if he was just a really good actor. But yeah, both of these characters were terrible people, but honestly, I was here for it. So if you're into like a kind of tamer thriller, I would say, then pick this one up. The next thriller I have to recommend is Sometimes I Lie by Alice Feeney, and I will read the like tagline to you guys because it's kind of what got me hooked when I first read it. But it says, "My name is Amber Reynolds. There are 3 things you should know about me. I'm in a coma, my husband doesn't love me anymore, and sometimes I lie." If you have watched any of my other thriller recommendation videos, then you know that I am a sucker for unreliable narrators, and this is the epitome of unreliable narrators. The story is told in alternating timelines from the past and the present, as well as diary entries that were written years ago. This is a thriller that you will not guess the ending to. I'm pretty good at guessing the endings, and I hate it when I'm able to. You'll honestly have so many guesses about how this book is going to end, and I guarantee you, you are going to be wrong, but it was so addictive, very fast-paced. Honestly, I'm still kind of confused with the ending, but in the best possible way. So if you're into thrillers like that, definitely check this one out. The next book I have is a YA thriller because I wanted to add something that will definitely not scare you if you are not into the, you know, scary thrillers. But it is Lies You Never Told Me by Jennifer Donaldson, and I actually have a full video review of this one if you want to check it out. I'll leave it down below. This follows Gabe and Elise, who both have a story to tell. Elise has never liked to be the center of attention, but then one day she ends up trying out for the school play and gets one of the leading roles, which gives her the attention of somebody very unexpected. And then it also follows Gabe, who is sick of the way his girlfriend Sasha treats him, so he ends up breaking up with her, and that's when she will stop at nothing in order to win him back, and it's like both of their stories. Like I said, this is a very tame thriller compared to some of the others that I usually talk about on this channel, but it's one where I should have seen the twist coming, but it's told in such a way that you don't see it coming, which is really surprising. But it's told in alternating perspectives between Gabe and Elise. Each chapter ends off in a cliffhanger and then switches to the next perspective, but it's done in a way that the story doesn't feel disjointed in any way, which is very surprising because I find sometimes when alternating perspectives, you're kind of jarred into the next storyline, but it just flows so nicely with this one. And I was intrigued with both of the perspectives equally, which I'm usually not like that. Usually I favor one over the other, but I was invested in both of these characters equally. But like I said, it's a very tame thriller compared to a lot of other things I talk about on this channel, so if that's your thing, then I would definitely check out this one. And then the final book that I have to recommend for this thriller recommendation video is Emma in the Night by Wendy Walker, and this follows 15-year-old Cass and 17-year-old Emma, who disappeared one day from their home, and that's when Cass returns telling a story about how the girls were kidnapped and held on this island by a husband and wife. So a forensic psychologist named Dr. Abby Winters is put onto the case, and she begins listening to Cass's story and realizes that some of the things that she's talking about are a little off. And it's the story of her looking deeper into the case while getting to know Cass and her narcissistic mother and how that all ties together into their story. If you've been on this channel for a while, you know that I am a big fan of mental illness and personality disorders, and to have an entire book based off of narcissistic personality disorder was so interesting to me. And like I said about Sometimes I Lie, I'm a big fan of unreliable narrators. Cass is definitely an unreliable narrator, so I was a big fan of that as well. I also think that the exploration of this dysfunctional family was really well done. It was very interesting to see the way that they manipulated each other. You get alternating perspectives between Cass and Dr. Abby Winters, which was a really cool way to dive deeper into the case and what the psychologist was thinking at the time about what was going on, but then also hearing Cass's story firsthand at the same time, because it was kind of like her analyzing it as she went, so that was really cool. But this was a very, very fast, very interesting take on a thriller, so I definitely recommend if you guys are into like personality disorders. That's a very like specific thing to be into, but you know, I am, so maybe somebody out there is too. All right, everybody, so that was my thriller recommendations video round 4 on my channel. Like I said earlier, the other videos will be linked down below if you want to check those out, and any relevant reviews will also be linked down below. Let me know a couple of recommendations that you guys have, because I'm always looking for new thriller books because it is my favorite genre. I'm the self-proclaimed thriller queen, so please let me know down below and let me know if you've read any of these books, what you thought of them, and I'll see you all in my next video. Goodbye!